here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Philips after it announced that demand in China slumped significantly in recent months. This sent shares of the Dutch medical devices maker, tumbling more than 16%. Also in focus, shares of Boeing, which is reportedly set to launch a plan to raise more than $15 billion in capital. Shares of the troubled plane maker are down 0.1% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Apple. That's after analysts at advisory firm Wedbush said the tech giant is on track to be the first company to hit $4 trillion in market capitalization. Apple shares are up 0.3%. And we're also keeping an eye on Volkswagen, which plans to shut at least 3 factories and lay off thousands of staff. Volkswagen shares last traded down by 0.7%. Asian markets kicked off the new week mostly higher. Japan's Nikkei 225 climbed 1.8% as the yen tumbled to a three-month low after Prime Minister Shigeru Ishiba's coalition lost parliamentary majority in an election drubbing over the weekend. Ishiba, however, indicated that he would stay on as Japan's leader, vowing to reform the Liberal Democratic Party. Here at home, the PSE index rose 0.4% in a shortened trading week.
It's very easy to get ahead of ourselves, though, especially that we didn't anticipate that, you know, inflation would actually fall this much further. And that's why we're seeing that the BSP could be very dovish in the next few meetings. When they give their policy their decision on the policy rates moving forward, no. But I think, you know, we have to consider what's happening not just locally but also geopolitically. With an aggressive rate cut, this might weaken the peso. I don't think the BSP wants that to happen. Too rapidly. 60% directly, indirectly of our CPI is tied to oil. So if there's any spike in prices, it's going to drive back inflation up again.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Olympus Corporation tumbled 5.6%, making it the worst performer on the Nikkei 225. That's after the endoscope maker sacked its CEO, Stefan Kaufmann, following allegations that he had purchased illegal drugs. Meanwhile, shares of Korea Zinc jumped 3.8% as the company secured more shares in a $1.5 billion buyback. This as it tries to fend off a takeover from its top investor. In local corporate news, BDO sees its net income climb 12% to 60.6 billion pesos in the January to September period. It cites a 13% increase in gross customer loans with double-digit growth in all segments. Total deposits also expanded by 10% year-on-year. As for Union Bank, its net income in the first 9 months of the year rose 6% as it recorded a 76% jump in third quarter earnings. The Aboitiz-led bank cites expanding consumer portfolio, which now accounts for 60% of its total loan portfolio. That's nearly 3 times higher than the industry average. To Lushutan's PNB Now, it booked a 15.1 billion peso 9-month net income, up by 12% on robust growth in net interest income. Its net interest income, which comprised 83% of total operating income, grew 10% to 36.5 billion pesos. Meanwhile, Aboitiz Equity Ventures records a consolidated net income of 18.8 billion pesos for the first 9 months of 2024, up 4%. Excluding non-recurring foreign exchange losses of 20 million pesos, the company's core net income for the first 9 months of 2024 would have gone up 9%. Breaking down the units, Aboitiz Power, which contributes 64% to total, saw EBITDA rise 12%, largely driven by higher generation portfolio margins and additional capacities from 2 solar plants. Its food and beverage unit, which includes Pilmico and now Coca-Cola Beverages, saw its contribution surge over 8 times to 4.2 billion pesos, while Aboitiz Infracapital recorded a net loss of 148 million pesos. And finally, a softness in demand for major home improvement and finishing construction supply dents Wilcon Depot's third quarter profit. The retailer posted a 33% drop in the July to September period, bringing its nine-month net income to 2.1 billion pesos, down by 22%.